Well, in honor of Women's Health Month, we thought it appropriate to talk about one of the biggest stressors in women's lives, and that can be money. We've got Kyle Wingfield of Finley Alexander Wealth Management. He knows a lot about strong women. He was raised by one. He's married to another, and we are happy to have him here for today's Money Monday. Our money man is offering some sound advice to women. How are you?
I'm doing well. I think another piece there is constantly surrounded by
them. Yeah.
So bless that one. Bless
absolutely that one. And you know what, it is great in theory, that idea that women are superheroes. We can do it all, we can take care of the kids and the house and our jobs and everything, but realistically it is also very overwhelming at times. And when we think about making a money plan, it just seems like one more huge task to add to the list.
Yes. And that's the thing. I mean, women are what I refer to, the CEO of everything, but let's face it, the plate's only so big. And one more thing, no matter what it is, can all of a sudden send you into overwhelm. And so I think really in money, I don't care, women, men, whoever, money can be very intimidating and very overwhelming. And a lot of us just go like this.
Yeah.
And so again, it doesn't have to be that way. So I'm glad we're having this conversation.
Right now, we know that many women are ascending to many C-suite positions. They are starting to out-earn men in some areas of the country. So we are seeing this shift in real time. So this is really important, this conversation that we're having.
Oh, yeah. And I like that we're seeing the shift in, quote unquote, real time. And that's true. Mm-hmm. But how many women have been behind the scenes for decades, for centuries, just making it happen? And now it's happening so much that it's forcing the world to acknowledge. And I think now it's also shifting how women see themselves when it comes to money, because so many, I think, have this, it's like society programs people a certain way. And sometimes they're like, hey, just let the guy take care of it.
They do.
And I'm like, nah, you know,
right.
He didn't wake up money smart. Nobody's money smart. Okay. So again,
right. I think that sort of mindset is something that we are all unlearning. I've unlearned that. I think, you know, when you've got your husband or your father or who, whatever male figure is in your life, a lot of times it is just sort of easy because society tells us, just give it to them. They know what they're doing, but they only know what they study the same way that we only know what we study. So if we study, we get it.
Yep. Yep.
So, and that is part of what you were talking about for Women's Health Month. It's just sort of embrace the planning process. It does not have to be that scary. Where do we start out? What should we be doing?
Well, it just really depends where you're on that arc, because there's accumulating money for the eventual work optional status or being retired. And then there's distributing or spending it, right? Like the whole purpose of saving money, Elsa, is to spend it. And we have no problem doing that when it's a one-off event. Save money for a wedding. Wedding comes, you spend it. Save money for a car. Time to buy a new one. You spend it. Get to retirement. Oh, gosh, I don't want to spend it because I'm scared I'm going to run out. And that's because retirement's not a one and done deal. It's an ongoing endeavor for another 30 or 40 years. So I think the first thing is, where are you on that arc? Are you getting close to retirement? Are you just starting out? You can't, saving is a habit. Investing is something you do once you've mastered the habit of saving. And then understanding, what are you trying to accomplish? What kind of lifestyle do you want to lead later when you stop working? And that can direct what you do. It's called purpose driven planning. What's the purpose of the money? That dictates where it goes.
Got it. All right. So of course we want to talk to you more. Get started with our planning. How should we reach out to you?
FinleyAlexander.com. Hit me up, send me an email. I'd love to connect with you and see how I can help you out.
All right, Kyle. Thanks so much for being with us. You always break it down in ways that we can digest. So I appreciate that. And we'll be right back with more Midday Maryland right after this. Stay tuned.